Good evening, everybody, and welcome to the weirdest episode of Average Giants.
Multiplayer Madness.
This is going to be crazy. So let me get in here. We'll show off what we're doing first. We're going to be playing some Assault Android Cactus, and we will be getting at least one or two people from Witchbeam in the call. When they're ready, they aren't ready yet, so we're just going to start off playing.
I'll just be like this.
Yeah. Giant, what should I call you? This is Cheesy McBroner, but you can just call him Giant.
That's a good one. I like the line as Boner's Cheesy.
Since we don't have Witchbeam here, could you give us a quick synopsis of the game before we start?
Oh boy, if I can remember, you play, what is it?
An Assault Android Cactus.
You know what? Press play and go to the tutorial and it tells you the story.
I can't. I'm not playing one.
Oh.
Here.
Oh, it's all good. pretty much for this game, what you're playing is...
Oh, no, that's me. Okay, sorry about that. So let's all just pick our characters then, I guess.
Yeah. So we're playing these androids and our ship has been taken over by evil robots. And we have to liberate the ship.
Did we find the ship, or did it...
No, we're on the ship, and then it gets taken over.
Because our cargo...
Does Abigine have Google Glass, or is she a Saiyan?
She's a Saiyan.
Yeah, that makes more sense.
Yeah.
Oh, hang on, real quick.
Super Saiyan.
Super duper.
Super Serial Saiyan.
Okay, so we're going to be starting the game here.
Whoops.
Yes.
I thought that it was, I thought it was a 6-hour difference.
No, it's an 8-hour difference.
But it's, I thought it was 18 hours.
I think it's an 8-hour difference.
I thought it was 18-hour difference.
Okay, so well, either
six
way.
6 hours behind, so that's totally my bad.
All good. When we get Witchbeam on here, we'll get them on here. So, this is pretty much a twin-stick shooter. Probably
sweet.
The easiest way to say it.
Pretty much it.
Let's just start from 1-1.
1-1, this end.
And we had these guys on the show once before, so everybody's color-coded. If you see lots of little yellow beams, that one's me.
I'm the red-haired beam, and I really don't know who's talking.
It's random.
It could be anybody.
I think it's whoever gets the pickups, actually.
And you can actually see who has the most points because they have a crown on their head.
Yeah. And we all have two different types of guns. We have our base ones, like mine is a spread shot, and then when I switch over, I have a rocket launcher that'll go on the cooldown after I use it.
Mine is a really, is an easier one to play because it's, a homing shot, and then if I want my special shot, I throw this, like, big metal ball at everything.
Woo! This is crazy!
It is pretty awesome. What do you guys think so far?
Shut down.
What character are you?
Oh, you have a helicopter.
You're Aubergine.
Aubergine.
You have to control her disc, which I'll let you know that it's a lot simpler when you're a single player because you can use keyboard and mouse.
Weapon maximum. Accelerate.
You never use keyboard and mouse and a twin stick either, right?
I don't use any sticks. I use a zero stick. That's what I do.
Weapon max. Accelerate.
I should also explain. So I'm your host tonight, Average Giant, with my co-host. I'm the average gamer with my co-host.
You're the average giant gamer.
Behind me is my amazing and beautiful wife, Whisper, and beside her is some dude.
Some dude.
No, that's Killer Peach.
I have a YouTube channel named Some Dude.
Yeah.
His name is Peach something.
Peach something.
Princess Peach.
If you're watching on YouTube, these guys will have links in the description if you want to say hi.
I win!
Yeah, but look at that wave of yellow.
I win.
Wait, I'm coming in here too. I chose my character because she has the same color hair as me.
Holly and then Lemon. Oh yeah, you winning, please.
And Aubergine. Coral got nothing. Coral got nothing. Who's Coral?
I got things.
Oh, sorry.
I got 12,000 things.
You got 12,000 things.
Alrighty, we're gonna get Matt in the call.
So I'll talk first.
I'm really
sorry. I honestly thought it was an 18-hour difference.
That's so good.
I feel like
here.
A dick. So you can just call me Dick Diggler or something like that.
I think that's a bit rude. How's it going, guys?
It's going pretty well. How about yourself? You picked the same level.
No, it's going good for me. I see you got four people playing now.
Yep. Yes. This is what we're calling this multiplayer madness. Ow.
I know.
Watch out for that.
But you're like cut in half.
Yes, I know. I'll be cut in half for most of it, so.
Still wearing the shirt though, so that's
yes,
the good.
I actually haven't taken it off since April.
Oh wow, that's kind of
the
disturbing.
Way that I wash it is that I actually wash myself in the washing machine.
It's really good that the internet cannot transmit smell. It is so overpowering.
I have like seven layers of Axon. Shut up.
Also, I wanted to show everybody in Canada, where we are located. This is what September looks like on an average day.
Oh, you can't see
even, oh, there we go. There we go. There's Canada in
see
September.
See that snow?
It is so much snow.
It's an actual snow warning right now.
Oh my god, that is crazy. You know it doesn't even snow where I'm from ever at any point in the year.
Well, it's because as I was talking to another guy in Australia, he was just like, oh, we don't get snow ever. I'm like, yeah, but 96% of everything in Australia can kill you.
That is a bit of a trade-off, isn't it?
Great.
So we had you on the show back in April, and I wanted to get you back on here because you guys have had some significant updates since then. Did you want to talk a little bit about them?
Sure. I mean, we've put in the seventh character, Shiitake. I think she's new since the last time we talked about it, as well as like the Infinity Mode, which I'm really, really proud of. I don't know if you had checked it out.
We should actually play that. I've seen Hanana Hammocks play that, and I was like, are you kidding me?
I also have not been able to unlock the seventh character because of your new boss.
Justice?
Yes.
Do you want to try him? I'll give you tips.
Oh, we will.
I tried playing Justice the day before my birthday, and I failed
you
so
ruined his
miserably.
Birthday.
I failed so miserably. I was like, what am I supposed to do? There's some magnets.
I'm glad to see that as the game goes further into development, you guys are not letting go of your stranglehold on difficulty, which is appreciated.
Hey, now, it's not too hard, though, compared to, like, traditional shmups. I mean, you want to jump into Ikaruga? I've never beaten the third boss in Ikaruga.
I don't think anybody has.
I'm sure everybody has.
It's just a
lie.
Yeah, exactly.
It's funny, I actually own Ikaruga for GameCube, except I can't play it because it's for a Japanese GameCube. So I've never actually been able to play it.
I had the same as well, but I re-bought it when it came out on Xbox.
Oh, nice. I had it for Dreamcast, but that was it.
That's where I remember playing it too,
oh, yeah.
And I kind of fell in love with its horrendously difficult situation.
I love Lemon, because once you get leveled up the whole way, I skim the outside of the map and just shoot into the center.
That's good. That's what you want to do.
Yeah, it's beautiful.
So with the twin stick, I tried playing Aubergine, and I just had a hell of a time.
She's a little bit trickier on Twin Stick because you're not just using a reticle to pick the kind of position that it shoots at. But basically her control is the direction that she's pointed in, it'll move out towards max distance in that direction. And if you let go of the trigger, it'll also... retract back towards where your character is. So you've got the duality of control. And hopefully that kind of works. So you can like swing around your facing and use it like a big wrecking ball, or you know, you can do the more controlled style of just releasing the trigger and going back and forward.
I really enjoy the different characters that you guys have a really unique feel with how you play them.
Like, thank you.
Mm-hmm. My fallback is always Lemon for the Contra... kind of the Contra-esque play style. I was always a spread shot man myself.
I love just the octopus arm that spreads out across the screen when you've maxed out.
Exactly. Because why do I need to worry about more enemies if I can just shoot the entire screen?
My thing is that I've always, my fallback is Holly naturally because I don't have to aim.
I just missed
the
battery. Oh man.
It's okay, you can come back. I believe in you.
Where am I? Okay, so I want to know, since I'll probably never be able to beat Justice.
We'll beat him
what
tonight.
What is shiitake like?
No. Beat him.
Just what I will still like play. Like, give us the basic info on it. Aw, damn it.
You will beat Justice.
I couldn't even get past the magnet part.
Yeah.
I'm here for you. I will give you the advice. All the advice you need.
The fact that this is the first time I think my wife has ever played this game, and I think Killer PG as well.
That's blasphemy, by the way.
That's not going to detract from
us beating
Justice.
That's totally blasphemy.
Like, I believe in you.
So how was PAX, by the way? Were you guys... You went to PAX Prime?
Yeah, we were in the Indie Mega Booth, which was awesome.
Oh, wow.
I love the Indie Mega Booth. It makes everything so much better, easier than the alternatives.
I was there not this year, but I was there last year. But that was kind of before I started the whole average gamer thing.
I was actually really aiming for being a part of PAX Prime this year, but then I totally forgot that you need money. And a passport, and
there are a lot of things that go in there. How was the trip, though? I mean,
wait, you need a passport to go there from Canada?
Yeah,
aren't you just like
you
American?
They
I thought you guys were America Light or something.
Not since 9/11.
Actually, that is pretty much it. After 9/11, they changed this. Like, you need there's three different ways of getting into the U.S. There's the Nexus card, which is for business.
Why do you know so much about this?
Well, you can get a Nexus payment if you get a Nexus card.
Or is it for it's for, yeah,
why
it's
do
for,
you both know so much about this?
My dad is an international trucker. My dad's going to get the second style of card, which is for business.
But, back on point, I was asking, how was your trip? How did you enjoy Seattle? I'm assuming that wasn't your first time.
I love Seattle. It feels like a big version of Brisbane, and a lot of people tell me that's because it's kind of like a mini Canada in America.
Yeah, it feels a lot like Vancouver around here.
It's lovely.
Yeah, beautiful city.
It's actually not the longest trip either, because it's on the west coast of America, so it's only about 15, 16 hours. You know, compare that to when I traveled to London last year, and that took me like 30-something hours.
Oh, crap.
So, I like
actually,
West Coast America is alright.
That makes sense. My wife, she traveled from, she went to New Zealand a couple years ago, and she was in transit for 39 hours.
Yeah, it's just nuts.
Also because things screwed up, and it was a bad time for her. The only good thing was that she actually sat next to William Shatner.
Really? Is he as weird in person as he is, like...
Apparently she didn't know it was him until after she got off the plane, but he made a really bad Star Trek joke.
That is awesome.
He's like,
and she didn't even know.
He asked her, he's like, so what are you doing here? And she's like, oh, I've been in transit from New Zealand for this long. He's like, oh, that's up. She's like, do you fly out? He's like, well, I used to. I used to, but now I only do it once a year. Because he was going to the Comic Con in Calgary a couple years ago.
Yeah.
That's when
he actually got one of the white cowboy hats.
Yep.
Wow. That's pretty cool.
Yeah. I can only
imagine you run into William Shatner and he just like makes terrible jokes.
Yeah, the funniest thing is that she didn't even know him until she texts me when she lands. She's like, who's the Star Trek guy? I'm like, William Shatner. I'm like, yeah, I think I sat next to him. I'm like, are you fucking kidding me? Pardon my French swear in English, but it's one of those moments where that's the only way that you can actually, you know, really explain it.
So, I was going to ask, since we have four people playing, which is ridiculous, is this ramping up the amount of mobs we have, or is it ramping up their stats?
It's ramping up the number of enemies. So what we do is we want the weapons to feel really strong and also have like a distinct difference between multiplayer and single player.
Okay.
So like when you get to full player, it is much more of a kind of party game atmosphere. There's just so many enemies, so much stuff happening. Whereas in single player, it's that much more tight, kind of controlled, tactical experience.
Yeah. And I'm sorry, PG and Whispered, I know you guys are being quiet. We told them that if they said a single word, we'd shoot them in the face.
Hello.
By shooting them in the face, we're just going to take our controllers and swing around and hit them. Be like,
wow.
There's a special move that you do where you can hold on to right here. And then you just go like that. And
did you guys update the sprite for Embryo?
No. It's the same. Should be.
Who pressed start?
Woo!
Oh, and who did the voice acting for all the characters now?
Well, we actually went and got Bay Area Sound to help us do like professional voice acting and hired people, and it's all very serious and legitimate compared to our normal efforts of just the bosses who are us and our friends doing them. So hopefully that was a good thing.
I'm a big fan of the starch for the voice acting. Shut down. Oh, good time.
Pineapple.
Who's your favorite? Yeah.
Little robots.
No cat.
Shoot.
Oh. Ooh. Starch is probably my favorite for the voice acting as well. She's just perfect.
Yeah. Oh yeah. It fits the character too. I like. I was gonna say. One of my. I wasn't talking about Starch. One of my favorite aspects is as you play the game, when you're going through the bosses, they have different flavor text for each android as you're playing them. So you learn little bits of like what the android did before this whole ship was taken over. And it's.
What's really? Yeah. Sorry, go ahead.
Oh, I was going to say, it was Starch was perfect because they were talking about how she was the prisoner that they were trying to hold. I was like, that makes so much sense.
Yeah, and it was really important to us to do that as well, to have the personality and the character come through. So we've got, you know, the different elements of each character's personality, the visual identity that comes across from their design being unique, the personality that comes across from having specific dialogue for each character with each of the bosses, and then also the gameplay identity that comes across from the fact that they all have you know, a unique set of weapons that give them a totally different playstyle. So hopefully that works out, that they're more than just like skins in a first-person shooter kind of thing.
Yeah, totally. I like the attention to detail that. I like the attention to detail where you guys have chosen to put the attention to detail. It's perfect.
Your attention to detail has lots of detail in it.
All right, so I'm going to give you some tips for this boss since I see you just died. He's tough, but you have to use your secondary weapons as much as you can. That means rockets on Lemon, which are whenever they're on full cooldown, which is like when you've got no ring around your feet, just swap over and blast them.
Okay.
And same thing with Carl. You can run up to him and drop down the plasma field right next to him.
Well, we're doing better than we did last time, that's for sure.
Much better.
Yeah, hit him with that cannonball, hit him with that plasma field.
It's a shame that we can't talk very much during this.
That is a problem with the game, is it's very hard to talk and play at the same time.
I totally forgot where I was and I was just shooting at nothing.
I may have been practicing a little bit.
Come on.
I'm going to rephrase that. I have been obsessed with this ever since the Justice update.
Oh, goodness. At least we're doing pretty good.
Doing good.
Somebody said Embryo's got a slightly nicer shader now. I got
him. Tim is always making small improvements to the characters, so yeah, they look a little bit better all the time. You gotta hit him with those secondary weapons.
I'm trying. He keeps moving out of the way.
Okay, battery. Okay, we're doing good, guys, we're doing good.
Where am I?
Four-player Embryo about to be beaten.
Again, I'm literally shooting at nothing.
Really? Because there's a giant boss in the room if you want to aim for him.
No, I feel like those walls are very menacing.
Yeah, that's true. Actually, if you want to work on an exit strategy, that would be perfect.
Hey, start shooting a hole in the wall?
Yeah.
Yeah! That's not a bad plan. Good job.
Wait, four-way high five, come on. One, two, three.
The white people!
That was messy.
Good job. See, you can totally beat Justice. I believe in you.
We got this.
But,
my
god, so basically our it might actually technically be a little easier to fight Justice because we can all each...
Congrats.
Nice.
Oh, you'd think it would be easier, but then we scale up the boss health and also the number of capture balls he spawns and things like that.
I was just thinking we could get rid of the magnets a little easier.
Yeah, you would think that.
But then, why do you have to harsh my buzz, man?
Do your bosses scale for
example? Yeah, so the bosses have to scale in a few different ways. The first thing is that they scale up the amount of health they have, because unlike the enemies, we can't just drop in a second boss. But for anything that they summon or spawn, like the magnet balls and things, we do actually scale up how many of those they summon. And the other thing we do is we scale up their attacks to either fire faster or fire more projectiles. So you notice when he was firing the rockets, he was firing at all four of you rather than just one.
Yeah.
Makes sense.
And how much playtesting goes into that kind of balance?
It's quite a bit. I mean, it's kind of the focus of our whole game is trying to make sure that it's fair and interesting and works for lots of different scenarios, different combinations. That's, I'd say, it's one of the more difficult parts of making this game.
Mm-hmm. I'm still sad that you didn't make a boss named Spirograph.
No, there's no Spirograph. There's Venom. There's question marks who's coming later on, but I can tell you that boss is also not named Spirograph.
But it's going to be Bullet Hell? Worse than usual?
No, I'm Bullet Hell.
I'll just say.
I know for the people in chat, we are not talking as much as we normally do in chat. Simply because we have four of us, and this setup isn't conducive to seeing our own chat box that well. So we apologize. People on YouTube, you can still leave comments.
Yeah.
We'll see those.
I'm still glancing over. Don't worry about it. It says, tweeted about the stream, four players awesome. Accelerating shutdown. So that's what we have.
Cool.
Can you settle a debate, Chris?
Settle a debate?
Yes. Settle a debate.
Because Coral is definitely a chick.
Yeah, Carl is definitely a chick.
Right?
They're all chicks.
We're just messing with you.
I was right.
No, you were right. You were right.
Of course. They're all female characters.
Actually, while we're having you on the stream, I was going to ask, because as you play the game, like I was saying, there are little snippets of like what the storyline is, but could you give us like an overview of the storyline for Saltander and Cactus?
Sure, yeah, because we don't have the intro cutscene yet. I mean, that's coming sooner or later. But the overview is that Cactus is a police android, and she's responding to a distress call from a space freighter called the Genki Star, which is a big ship that you're actually on all the time. She shows up, the Genki Star is there, everything looks fine. She goes, I'm going to get in a little bit closer and see what's going on. And it turns out that the Genki Star is totally not fine, and it starts shooting at her with its anti-asteroid defense system, stuff that's not designed to be shooting at friendlies, right?
Yeah.
And she ends up crash landing on the ship, discovering that there's these other androids there who also seem to be fine and unaffected by whatever's gone wrong, but all the robotics on the ship are responding in a bad way and gone crazy.
Have they gone rogue?
They have gone rogue. And so she, combines with these other androids and decides to start clearing the ship, and that's when you make your way through, you talk to the bosses, you find out what's gone wrong, and eventually you'll uncover the secrets of what's happened. That's also why you find the other androids as you go through, because they're, as you defeat the boss, you're kind of discovering other androids that were in different parts of the ship.
Meeting up with them kind of thing. That's cool.
Yeah.
I know Lemon was the medical officer before everything went to...
And Holly was the secretary.
Really?
I'm pretty sure Holly was a secretary, right?
Yeah, Holly was the... She's like the bookkeeper.
Okay, cool. That's why she's so nervous about everything. Don't tell me that we're stuck here.
Oh nice!
I got him.
Yay, Holly.
That wasn't me.
Oh, wasn't you?
No.
I thought it was your auto-aim shots that hit him.
No.
I torched him through the wall, apparently.
Oh, goodness. Oh, jeez. Where's our... Here it is.
We got it. Those red ones have a bit more life, guys, so use your secondary weapons on those. Okay.
I don't believe you. I'm just going to walk randomly. Where am I? Oh, so alive. Hey, look at that.
Go figure.
It looks to me like you're doing just fine.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah,
I don't even know what you were complaining about difficulty earlier.
See, it's because, I was using Aubergine. I was using Aubergine, and I couldn't figure out what the hell I was doing. Because I actually... The problem with Aubergine when you're using Twin Stick is that there's actually dissociation between the character and the weapon.
Yeah, you need to focus on two different points at once, which is very tricky, but also makes her interesting to me.
It does.
Yeah, I like it. I really like it.
If you want a challenge, like, I used Aubergine when I was playing single player. Man, I kicked so much ass, I didn't even realize it. And then when I played this, it was like, I see me, but I don't see my weapon. Oh, wait, now I see my weapon. I don't know where I am.
Oh, man. I'm not doing well.
Where's the battery? It's oh, my God, the battery's... Run! Run, batteries!
Oh, we're all dead.
So what's your favorite character to use?
I actually like playing as Peanut, but she's not in the game yet. You'll see Peanut soon. She was at PAX. She's cool.
Peanut!
Are you going to go straight to Justice? Are you going to try the hard stuff? Yeah, Peanut. She's cool.
We have a lot of this episode to go.
We still have to figure out which Take is before we get to the amazingness that is Peanut.
Well, this level can be a little bit tricky for Battery. You have to be very careful to kind of... Yeah, you have to make sure you never miss any of them.
This is really close
that's
quarters.
Would you mind giving us a little teaser about Peanut?
No, because we got a weird computer. Just like with the other one.
Well, the other one didn't show this
Sorry.
Episode. Oh, okay. We can't show Peanut this episode.
Well then, why don't we just know? Accelerate extended. Yes, tell us
Well, Peanut, she's pretty rad. She's very different from the other androids. Peanut uses a combination of magma welder and rocket lance. Oh, actually, I think we called it Giga Drill. And basically, her primary weapon is a big splatter gun, very heavily inspired by like the bio gun from Unreal Tournament, or even the weapon in Splatoon that just launches out a splattering of stuff. And so it hits the enemies and it'll melt them on contact. But if it doesn't hit them and it hits the ground, it'll actually stick on the ground and create a like little surface that lasts for a little while. And if enemies walk on it, they'll take damage as well. Now, her secondary weapon's the only weapon in the entire game that actually moves the characters around. So we wanted to give her a mobility weapon, something that just behaves totally different to anything else you've experienced. So it's a giant drill with a rocket on the back. And when you fire it, you get propelled across the stage and you can hit enemies and kind of pin them and then drive them through other enemies to damage them, or even pin a big enemy against the wall to like instantly defeat them.
Oh, interesting. Yeah, I like the sound of that.
You said that it's gonna like the magma thing's gonna melt the bad guys. Is there gonna be a different animation for their death?
No, it still just defeats them. But that's the idea is that's why it damages them because really it's cool. Magma.
Very cool.
Accelerate.
I think we're doing okay. I don't really know.
You seem to be doing okay. You're near the end. Just make sure you don't miss any of those batteries.
No, I got the battery. I got it. I love the little the prancing toasters that shoot missiles.
It always makes me think of the Brave Little Toaster.
See, they always get half the people see them think toaster, and the other half of the people who see them think little dogs.
I thought dog toasters.
I thought they were pigs.
Dog toasters. That works.
Oh god, that's a battery. Okay, we're
good. I call them Fidos.
Fidos.
Oh, I murdered that one. Oh, it's because I only died once. We got 19th place. We're awesome. So the leaderboard's on this one. It's all that leaderboard is only for 4-player.
Every single time that you play, it bases the leaderboard based on the number of players because we don't want people competing an unfair unfair matchup, right?
Because if you get more enemies in 4-player, you can get bigger chains. Kind of thing. It didn't suit you
anyway. Yeah.
That makes sense.
Smurt. So we're not doing very good then. Either that or not very many people have played, managed to play 4-player.
I would be tempted to think the prior.
Badasses? Yeah. Our asses are bad.
Yes, they are.
You are badasses.
This game is like, this game would be great. I have a 55-inch TV in my house. And
yeah.
I would love to just get Assault Android Cactus on it. I do have Steam on that computer, so it's not like it'd be difficult.
Yeah, it runs on just about anything. Alternatively, it's eventually going to come out for consoles if we can ever finish it, which
is
soon.
What is a console?
Like, okay, this is a weird question. Will you ever port this to a Vita?
Yes.
Oh,
we had it on
God.
Vita at GDC, actually. Which
really?
Was really
cool.
How does that work?
I am all... Well, I get twin sticks on the Vita.
Oh, it's just going to be single player, though. Unless
yeah,
you can,
single player.
Unless you can, like...
I'm so down with that. I would play that so often. And I should be... Weapon maximums. I was going to ask, what was your favorite PAX story this year?
Tim Schafer came around and played the game, actually, which was
Whoa,
pretty cool.
Really?
Yeah, I
That's
thought so.
Cool.
I got the
and I was not there, unfortunately, but it's still the coolest moment because Tim Schafer played this game. And then I tweeted him later. I was like, oh my God, I can't believe I wasn't there when you came around and played it. He tweeted back that it was super fun and thanks. So for me, that's, you know, that's the highlight. I'm going to ask him later if I can put that on the store page. I don't even care. Just like get a good review. It doesn't matter.
As far as the current indie market goes, that's pretty much a stamp of approval.
It is. It's a good moment for me. Otherwise, it was just like just so many people coming through and playing the game and enjoying it, which is always exactly what you want, right? It's just people playing the game, liking it, telling you they liked it, and it's working out like that. Because ultimately, that's why we make games, right? For you people to play them and enjoy them. So PAX is amazing that just so many thousands of people coming through. I think we had at least 1,000 people come through and play the game across the 4 days, which is just huge in our tiny little booth.
That is awesome.
Oh my God. Man. Oh my God. Kill the last two things. Are you kidding
me? No! Dang it.
You failed on the last two?
You died at the same time. That was the problem.
Well, that's because the battery went down.
Yeah, if you guys didn't regenerate, you guys
would... Came close. You came close.
Not close enough.
I like how the secret people in the back of the room are making gestures and things occasionally as their method of non-verbal communication.
Do you guys have any questions that we can ask him? Shut up!
Secret questions.
Here's your 10-second window to speak. Yo.
Hey, I'm around whenever. Sorry that I wasn't there from the start of the stream, though.
Oh,
I
was
just...
That was totally
my fault, thinking that you... Seriously, it's 11 a.m. there?
It is 11:43 right now.
Oh, man.
Time zone suck.
Why did I think it was 18 hours?
I don't know.
You're on the other side of the Australia?
Yeah, possibly if I'm down in like Adelaide or something, that's 18 hours.
You're on the west side of the upside down.
Oh man, these
Whoa.
Stupid mines.
Yeah.
Whoa, that's a lot of mines.
Is that more than you've ever seen?
It's not more than I've ever seen, but this is one of the more mine-heavy sections in the game. A good trick you can do with the mines like that is you use the weapon swap because you're invulnerable while you're swapping there, so it can be kind of like a dodge. Get out of jail free.
Most useful thing I've learned thus
far. Are we screwed already? Oh, you got it.
You're doing good. You're using your secondary weapons a lot, which is like the real key to victory in Cactus.
Yeah. Oops. Well, the secondary weapons I usually find have so much splash damage that when you have like a 4-player game like this, it's required.
Yep. Yeah. And the tricky thing is as well, like if you're getting knocked down a lot, the secondary weapons damage doesn't scale with weapon ups. You don't need to level it up. It just always does how much damage it does.
Oh,
so
yeah.
As soon as you kind of can use it, it's a good idea to use it. And unless you have like a max level main weapon, at which point you can kind of use it a little bit more sparingly and just in good situations.
Mm-hmm. You can really tell how difficult or engaging a game is by how much your fingers hurt playing it.
Hopefully they don't hurt too much. Maybe I need to change the control scheme.
No, I'm just holding down really hard with
I like the minimalistic view you guys have towards the control scheme and the UI. It lends itself well because you have to pay attention to so much in the game.
Yeah. And eventually we want to offer like usability options there as well, because we know that there are people with like muscle atrophy issues that have trouble holding down on the control pads. So we'd like to at some point add some options for auto shooting or auto, even auto movement or auto aim type configurations that will never be as good as if you're, you know, focused and kind of, that like there won't be a replacement for getting the highest scores in the game, but there'll be a method for people to appreciate and enjoy the game if they physically are unable to at the moment.
Mm-hmm. Flax Cycle says two tips. You can mash A to get up instead of using the triggers, and you can hit Y to identify your character.
Mm. Yes.
Everyone's gonna hit Y at the same time.
And they will they'll say their own name as well, so you can totally annoy each other by just saying Holly.
Okay, you yep. That's awesome. But I have a yellow ring and I shoot yellow shots, so that's easy.
I think Coral's my favorite.
Coral's your favorite?
Yeah.
What is Coral's weapon?
Like shotgun thing.
Oh, the shotgun.
It's funny because you establish your favorite character pretty quick.
Yeah.
Playing.
Yeah.
So like,
the first time I tried Lemon, I was like, well, I'm done.
Although technically that's just kind of like a Super, or like Smash Brothers, where you play a character and you're like, I like this.
Yeah.
I'm going to make it. I'm going to get better.
But it's more like Ninja Turtles in that the
No, hang on.
The Ninja Turtles were designed to be different archetypes or personalities. So, like, a certain type of person will choose Donatello, and that means that you can, you know, categorize people in the world as Donatellos or Leonardos.
No,
that's
here.
True.
No, sorry. Everybody wanted the staff because they had the longest reach.
What?
That is actually
what?
Also
no,
true.
I mean,
in the video game.
Yeah,
The video game, Donatello is by far the best character.
Oh, yeah. Oh, unquestionably.
Fight over it.
No, but no, it's totally true with the four characters. What we tried to do is the starting four are archetypal type characters so that you can find someone you really like identify with. And then after that, we go crazy and they're much more niche. So Starch and Aubergine, Shiitake, and Peanut are all designed so that we're going to have a lot more love-hate relationships with them, I think.
Interesting, yeah. That's a good way to say that for Starch and Aubergine. That I know. I haven't played Shiitake or Peanut yet, but yeah, that's perfect.
Are you going to make it possible for there to be an 8-person multiplayer?
I'm not sure that the levels are big enough to cope with that. They're pushed to the limit in 4-player already.
That'll
be fun, though.
Assault Android Cactus 2, the 4v4 MOBA style.
Yeah.
That would be insane as a MOBA.
This
would, I don't know if I would want to play that.
This would be an interesting game in a PvP sense.
It'd be like Magicka the MOBA.
It's tricky in that PvP logically makes sense. You go, oh, it'll work because you've got the different weapons and the different character types and things like a fighting game. But then we've actually tested it and tried it and built it when we first started working on the game. And the trickiest bit is that everyone moves at the same speed and you have so few hit points that PvP doesn't actually work. You end up basically in this kind of stale position where weapons that have a higher chance of hitting dominate. Like, you can't catch someone to use the shotgun on them, you know, if you're all moving
at
the same speed.
What you're saying is that Lemon wins.
Oh, actually, Holly wins. Holly wins.
Oh, yeah, right, Holly, of course.
That's why.
But the cannonball
so well
is the most useless weapon in PvP.
Oh, yeah, right.
It's the slowest weapon.
Who's gonna hit? Who are you gonna hit with a cannonball in PvP? Nobody's
gonna
stand still for the 10 seconds it takes for him to reach you.
You're not gonna hit anybody that's ever gonna admit to it.
You'd have to really try to shoot ahead at everything.
Yep, and that's why Holly and Starch's rockets and things. And so that's why we decided not to do it. I mean, it was actually, like, technically it's not that hard of a thing to do, and we had it up and running at one point, but we decided some stuff is fun to toy around with, but shouldn't be part of the game.
Yeah.
Well, makes sense. Oh, I heard it.
We're at Vespula.
No.
I get hesitant to talk about stuff we've decided not to put in the game because a lot of the time people assume that if you didn't put something in the game, it's because you didn't have the time, not because it wasn't a good idea.
Yeah. Which brings me to one of our most popular questions. What is the hardest thing you ever had to take out of the game?
Well, it's not finished yet, so I don't know if I can answer this question, because what if we have to cut something really important?
That's fair, that's fair.
We'll cut the Android part out of the
business. Yes.
So this is Vespula.
We've had some weapon concepts that I thought would be cool that we ended up just not toying around with. That I'd like to come back and try and see if they're interesting one day. But generally, if we didn't include something, it's because we found that it didn't fit or that we had something that would be a better use of that time.
Yeah.
I don't think we've really cut anything yet that I'm really unhappy about not being in the game.
This is the one where, this is where Aubergine absolutely shined for me.
Yeah, oh
like,
yeah.
Up until I tried,
you can get past that swarm so
yeah, like
easily.
Up until I tried Aubergine, I was having a hell of a time trying to actually beat her.
Okay, guys, just if you can focus all the swarm with your secondary weapons and just keep them at bay.
Yep.
It is good, actually. I like the coral bug zapper. That's what Carl's secondary reminds me of in this stage, is like, you know, those anti-mosquito things.
Yeah. Damn it.
We're doing good damage. We're doing good damage. So that part is good. We just need to avoid the bullet guys.
She gets trickier.
Yes, she does. I really, really enjoy this boss though. Oh, man.
We purposefully went with a boss design for this boss that didn't just rely on bullet hell, because we wanted to showcase that, like, there's going to be more to the game. Mm-hmm. And even though some of the other bosses are more pure bullet hell type things, like Venom's got a lot of bullet hell, which is going to be interesting people try it. We thought it was important that, like, we showcase that there can be variety in game. You should be prepared for anything.
Yeah, that's what I said. Ooh, 198 chain.
I'll try not to talk too much while you're fighting the boss, because I know it's hard to talk and think.
Not a problem. I'm starting to get used to it at this point. It's only taken me about 8 months.
Oh, come on, you can do this.
Oh, that was a good shot.
You can do this. Yeah, this is her third phase.
Got it.
I love your bosses. The way you introduce them is so intuitive. And like, first phase, here's your mechanics. And then second phase, here's your mechanics. And then however many phases you have. And then the last phase, it's like, okay, you learned everything, now deal with everything.
Shoot!
All together.
Crap, come on, we can do it. Oh, we didn't do it.
Oh! It's okay, we can do that.
Yeah, we always have to die. Woo! Once. We're so close, though.
What time is it? Okay.
You were on the edge.
After we beat Vespula, we'll go.
Okay, there's
to
a
justice.
Question really quick. So why did you guys make all the characters squirrels?
Oh, that's a good question. Yeah, how come you guys chose to make all the main characters women?
Well, everything's a conscious decision to some degree, so what it started out with was we designed Cactus as a character and a personality, and then we built out some of the other characters that that she was going to be hanging around with when we realized that we needed characters in the ship to fill out the world, to build some of the storyline, and also characters that would work in the sense of multiplayer and other archetypes, I guess. And they all just happened to be female at the time. Like, a lot of the designs were female interesting. And at some point, we sat there and we thought, all right, we have, you know, three or four female characters that almost like these were just interesting things. It wasn't on purpose that everyone was going to be female at the time. And then we worked out we had a theme that they were all female, and we decided to just stick with that. So from then on, we did start thinking of any new characters we were going to introduce were going to be female. And So it was equal parts, like, it just worked out that way. But then once we realized that was a theme of the game that we'd actively developed, mm-hmm. we decided to stick with it and make sure we kept it.
Yeah, I like that. It's good that you guys made it as a conscious effort. I know people like my wife probably appreciates that greatly.
Yeah, it's important to us that you can, have kick-ass female characters, because it's, I guess, non-typical as well.
Yeah, and it should be more typical than it is.
I like too how casual it is that they came out. Like, it's not like, look, they're all girls.
Yeah.
Yeah, they just happen to be females, and they're awesome, and they do stuff. You know, it kind of reminds me of my favorite. Well, I hate to make the comparison because this movie is amazing, but like in Terminator 2, you have the awesome, Sarah Connor, and she just kicks ass. And I always thought it was cool when you can do that. And it's the point is not to look at it and be like, oh, she's a girl. It's like, oh no, she's just awesome. Oh, yeah. You missed the battery.
No.
Might just have to try justice.
See the battery.
No, we got time. We got time for one more.
6 minutes. We'll do justice.
We can do 10 minutes over anyway. So we were 10 minutes late.
Yes, that's true. Right.
Reach our level in.
Secondary weapons as much as you can.
Anyway, we're out of that. Go. Secondary.
All right. So the trick of justice, if you're you're back onto her. All right.
Yeah,
we're gonna
try again. Yeah.
I'm going to give you some tips for justice while you're taking Vespula down. So, tricks for justice. First of all, take down the laser emitters in the first phase as soon as they spawn, because they will drop really cool power-ups. So you want to grab like shutdowns and fire powers, things that let you stop him and do a ton of damage. But only 3 power-ups can be on the field at once, so make sure you're not taking down the emitters like so fast that you can't grab the power-ups that are spawning.
Okay.
After that, you really just need to lay into him. Try and avoid hitting his front big armored plates, because they'll deflect all your bullets. So if you're someone like Holly who relies on a pinpoint precision strike, maybe try and get around behind him or just right up close so you can go through and thread the needle. And yeah, just use your weapons as much as you can. Use the power-ups as much as you can. In phase two, you just need to spread out a little bit so he doesn't run you all down simultaneously. And try to take him out. Like, deal as much damage to him as you can, even when he's spraying out his rockets. We've actually made him a little bit easier in the upcoming version we're going to be putting live soon, when we finish up and can have Peanut in the build. But not too much easier. He's about as hard as we want him to be. Just, I think maybe he'll get about 5-10% easier in the next version.
I really love, you guys have some amazing bosses. Like, it's hard to make
bosses. Oh, we missed the battery.
I've seen him in, like, say, Mega Man or World of Warcraft. It's what I would compare your guys' types of bosses to.
Thank you. Mm-hmm. I love the boss design in Mega Man. And World of Warcraft actually is one of the interesting things about it compared to other MMOs is I feel like they did a lot of work to make sure their bosses were interesting. So yeah. I appreciate the comparisons.
No, not a problem.
She's going down this time, I believe. Just use those rockets. Go use those rockets.
Yep, secondary as much as you can, guys. Shoot.
Come on. Yay.
Yeah. Okay, 1, 2, 3.
You are the champions.
Oh, man.
I like this. The stream's not, like, epically delayed like certain other streaming services.
Yeah. That is one nice
I thing. Did not die once.
Yeah, look at that score.
And you still like scored more than I did.
244 chain.
Oh man, that was pretty awesome. I'm just gonna say
you got that rank spread five.
On those bugs.
Yeah.
You got rank 5.
Okay, straight to justice.
Oh, this.
You're rank 5 in the world at full player Vespula. That's pretty
holy.
Good.
Wow, guys.
Nice.
And now it's time to take all that confidence and shove it down the toilet.
This is gonna suck. I have no.
I saw you trying to play this guy.
Keyword there is trying.
Processing. It wants to process our butts.
Yeah. Oh, man. Okay, so those security hand thingies will block your shots, too.
Okay.
Oh, good to know.
So if we can flank, try to. And anytime you see anything come out of it, shoot it.
Okay.
Just shoot.
Are you guys ready?
Focus ads. Yeah, we're ready. Focus ads. Okay. And keep moving. Keep moving.
Establishing.
Okay, see, there's three of them coming out. One's way down here. They'll kill you.
Oh,
and then these things you have to kill right away. Okay, we're good. We're okay if like one or two beams are up. I mean, it's manageable as long as we kill those orbs. Because those orbs will handcuff you and drag you into the beams.
Oh, shut down.
Get it.
Okay,
good.
Oh, I should actually use that.
Lots of damage. A little bit more and we have a battery. Here comes the battery.
You're doing well.
Good start.
I mentioned I rated
one. Oh, he's running.
Watch out, he will run.
Oh.
Okay, we got this. We got his secondary weapons, guys.
I'm behind him. I'm shooting his butt.
Front load a lot of damage
his
here.
His butt shall be shot more so than
Oh, man.
This is crazy.
Area damage.
I haven't actually seen this far because I died so quickly.
We need to do more damage.
Oh.
We're not getting
it's good, you're doing damage. Just keep using your secondary weapons. And a trick you can do, if you fail and you fight him again, try and save some of the power-ups next time for this phase.
Oh, okay, that makes sense.
Oh, you're so close.
Good first attempt.
We were actually pretty close to beating him there?
No. We were a little over halfway.
Oh.
Okay, let's go.
Containment protocols. Ah, didn't die right off the bat.
Why do you resist?
Never mind, I lied.
Yeah, two of you did. Okay, we got one right down low.
Not that. Definitely not me. I'm not believable.
Crap, can't get that one.
Try not to pick up power-ups if you can.
Ow!
That was a jerk. They run out, don't they?
No.
Oh, shoot! Okay, I can get this one now, at least.
Okay, get the ads.
Grab some of those power-ups.
Yeah, you are power-up.
Because you can only have three on the field at a time.
Oh, you can only have three on the field?
Yeah.
Okay,
yeah.
So keep three on the field.
Yeah, but if you're destroying those pillars, like, you want to be grabbing the power-ups, right?
Cool.
So that they can spawn new ones.
Cool.
Oh, yeah. Forgot. Don't forget, guys, switching over to
secondary
weapon
makes
you
a
little bit.
Yep.
Whoa! Goodness.
You're doing okay.
Jeez.
I believe.
Oh, snap. Nothing, no warning. You killed me.
That's how it really is. Just straight up kills you.
No, please!
Whoa!
Kind of a jerk face.
Right?
He is a jerk face. That's why he's slightly less of a jerk face after the next update. Okay. Oh my god, you actually got him really close to the next phase.
Let me out of a battery.
He drops one.
This is exactly
he's on the edge.
This is exactly how it went with Vespula the last time we had you guys on the show. And then we beat Vespula right at the end. Last minute.
Alright, I believe in you. This is it. This is the time.
This is it. But yeah, let's try and pick those off as quick as we can.
Ow! Don't pick them all off. Only pick three off and then leave some up.
Well, you get three, you kill three, and then you pick up the power ups, and then you kill the other ones.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
We don't want that.
I don't want to speak.
Okay, what is this gonna be? Shut down?
Yeah, do it.
Shut down.
Okay.
Ow.
Okay. Shut down. Okay, secondaries.
I feel like I'm not doing any damage to him.
Oh, you are, though. He's got his health. It's a big segmented health bar.
Oh, yeah, that's right.
Ooh, and there's a power up at the top, so someone can grab that.
I touched it. There we go.
You got it? Shut down. Somebody got this. Oh,
yeah. Secondary for the shutdown.
Good.
Oh, shoot.
Get up. Oh!
Jeez,
that was close.
Ah! Ah! Rockets in my face!
Nope.
Come on. Oh! Yeah, it was my warning. Jeez. Jeez.
Like
oh, you're doing really good damage this time, so just keep it up.
Oh, damage!
Don't forget when you die, it wastes, or not wastes, but it uses a lot of battery to bring you back up.
Oh, so close!
Grab it! Come on!
Shoot! Okay, we got one more, I think.
One last one? Okay.
Oh, if only the battery.
If Nick doesn't mind. Other Nick.
No, you're on cool. The
third Nick.
I'm cool.
You're on the edge.
Here, have one of these. No, don't hit me. That's rude. Shut down. Okay, we have three up.
Okay.
Okay, leave the other two. I'll use two.
Or just grab all the power ups and then shoot them. There you go.
Why do you resist? Ooh, that was a close.
Oh, there's that thingy. Go away.
I don't even know if we're doing good or not.
You can see in the bottom of the screen.
Doesn't make a difference to me.
You're doing fine, actually. You're going to defeat him and you're going to have a bunch of power ups left over.
Shut down.
Secondary for damage. Okay, now grab the other shutdown.
Last one. Okay.
Got it.
Whoa!
Okay, secondary for damage.
Whoa!
Oh, jeez. More. Okay, there's just
next battery.
Third phase. Holy good
now
lord.
Now we deal with everything.
Whoa, nope.
Wow.
He stood up. This is a new phase completely.
Oh, shut
you
down.
Not
grab
got it.
I'm sorry. Totally. Forgot how to brain and
we
I
got a full
it.
Battery, guys, so let's just keep doing damage soon. Just be smart about it.
Whoa!
Taste
the blue, please.
Shoot.
Blue?
Oh my gosh.
Shut down. Okay.
Another shutdown of hitness.
Okay.
But that didn't work at all. Oh, it did.
Oh, it did. He was just in the middle of
an animation. Keep shooting
it. Oh, whoa! Oh my god!
Kick a laser.
We can do this. Keep it up.
Yeah!
Victory!
One, that was harder than it needed to be.
But get it, New York's bad.
How did you follow that?
Oh, that's awesome. I'm glad you stuck with it.
How could you?
That's why every time we have you on the show, it's in the last minute we beat this
one. Oh,
so let us know when Venom's coming out. We need to get you back on the show so we can beat that one too.
Sounds like the fire alarm for my building is going off.
One, two, three. Oh, yeah, it does.
Oh, sorry.
That's just from our epicness. We
no, I'm pretty sure that's the fire alarm, but there's no fire. It was raining earlier. Whenever it rains, the fire alarm goes off.
Oh, that's good.
Sixth worldwide. Hit A.
Oh, you got Shiitake.
Yeah, we got her. And that's going to have to wait for the next one, because we're going to go let you deal with the fire alarm. And we're going to get our second show on here.
All right. Thanks, guys.
Thanks so much for joining us.
Thank you very much.
Hello, secret new people at the back.
Don't talk to them! Oh, sorry.
All right. For everybody in the stream, we'll be back in probably like 2 or 3 minutes. We just want to tweet some stuff out, and then we'll be playing some Hard Lander.
Buy this game. Right. Buy the game.
Buy the game now.
Thank you. All right. Good night.
Night.